Okay, I request everyone to please stand and open with me your Bible, the book of Genesis, chapter 50. We'll be reading from verse 15 up to 21. We'll read this all together. Genesis 50, verse 15 to 21. Starting from verse 15, ready? Read. And when Joseph's brethren saw that their father was dead, they said, Joseph will peradventure hate us, and will certainly requite us all the evil which we did unto him. And they sent a messenger unto Joseph, saying, Thy father did command before he died, saying, So shall he say unto Joseph, Forgive, I pray thee now, the trespass of thy brethren and their sin, for they did unto thee evil. And now we pray thee, forgive the trespass of the servants of the God of thy father. And Joseph wept when they spake unto him. And his brethren also went and fell down before his face, and they said, Behold, we be thy servants. And Joseph said unto them, Fear not, for am I in the place of God? But as for you, ye thought evil against me, but God meant it unto good, to bring to pass, as it is day, to save us people from this sin. Let's pause in a word of prayer. Lord, we thank you for this wonderful evening, wonderful day that you have given to each one of us. Lord, we thank you for how you bless our life, Father God. It's a manifestation of your goodness and your faithfulness to us, Father God. But tonight we are here to praise you and to worship you, your holy name, Father, and to hear from you, Father. Lord, the Holy Spirit may speak to us through your word. Use me as your vessel, Father God, to relay your message to your people tonight. Lord, we ask you to bless us now and for this we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Be seated. Our theme for this month is about constrained by the love of God to honor the Lord. But the Lord impressed upon me this message because we cannot honor the Lord if we are living in sin. So we need forgiveness before we can honor the Lord. Amen. So our subject for tonight is about forgiveness changes everything. The day we got saved changes the status of our life, our spiritual status in life. We became the sons of the devil, we belong to the family of the devil, but the day we got saved, it changes everything. We became sons of God, we became a child of God. Amen? So that's how forgiveness is very vital and important in before honoring the Lord. So tonight, we'll be studying the life of Joseph. Just a trivia, who knows the name of, Egyptian name of Joseph? Joseph. Knows the name? Egyptian name of Joseph. His name is Zaphnath-Paaneah. So, forgiveness changes everything. One of the most dangerous traps you will ever experience in your life is Satan's trap of unforgiveness. By the way, you have all the answers in the outline, so no need to write. I believe you are, you don't have a pen, so I put all the answers in the program. So it's, that's how I teach in the university. Open notes. Okay, so I want everybody to pass. Amen? So, one of the most dangerous traps you will ever experience being the Son of God is Satan's trap of unforgiveness. Bitterness can be toxic. Bitterness can be toxic. It can be like a radioactive waste. It can build up inside your heart until everything becomes bad. Something wrong about every place, and you cannot even trust other people or even the church. Toxic people who allow bitterness to rule in their hearts and lives have many difficulty with many different kinds of relationships. So that is the effect of bitterness. According to Hebrews 12:15, it says here, looking diligently, lest any man fail of the grace of God, lest any root of bitterness springing up trouble you, and thereby may it be defiled. Many have been defiled in our thinking one toward another because of our lack of forgiveness. We have been defiled because of our lack of forgiveness to other person. If there was some who could be angry and bitter in the Bible, it was Joseph. Why? First we see Joseph was sold into slavery, not by people who are making money, but by his own brothers. Joseph was sold when he was 17 years old. We can find that in Genesis chapter 35. When he was 17 years old. And his brother sold him to the Ishmaelites as a slave. Second is Jesus was placed into prison, which he don't deserve. But for something he had never done. Here is a man who could have become very much bitter against God, against his brothers. But instead, because of the grace of God in his life, he became much better man, a man of God. Amen? Amen. He became much better man of God. We can see in Joseph's life a picture and type of the Lord Jesus Christ. We can see many similarities. Joseph was sold at the price of 20 pieces of silver. That's the price of a slave. And Judas betrayed the Lord Jesus Christ for just an amount of 30 pieces of silver. Joseph was rejected by his brethren. The same thing with the Lord Jesus Christ. He was rejected by his countrymen or his brethren. John 1:11. Joseph was so loved by his father. Jesus was so loved by the father. Joseph suffered for doing what was right. Jesus suffered for doing what was right. Joseph also was promoted from the prison up to the palace, who take rulership over the great nation. The same thing with the Lord Jesus Christ. He was promoted from an empty tomb, in order that one day he will rule and reign in the earth, which we know him. And so we learn many things about Jesus by studying the life of Joseph. And it was the Lord Jesus Christ who said on the cross, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." And so tonight, I want you to think about the issue of forgiveness in your life and how you do and practice forgiveness in our life. How we practice forgiveness in our life. So we have three points here tonight. First is the failure of friendship. Failure of friendship. Letter A is the hatred of brethren. That is chapter 37. You can find that in Genesis 37, 3-4. But before that, let's have a glimpse on the family of Joseph. Joseph was Jacob had four wives, two wives and two concubines, and there are 12 brothers in or 12 sons in the family. So could you imagine how gaano kahirap yung pakikitungo ng bawat isa? Because Joseph was so loved by Jacob. You know, oftentimes the most difficult hurts that we can experience in our life are from those people who we know we love the most. People that we do not think who could hurt us. Sometimes we experience hurts because we have cared so much in the first place. This is the truth in the life of Joseph, because it wasn't a total stranger who sold him into slavery, but it was in fact by his own brothers. And so because of their hatred to Joseph, they made a plot that would eradicate Joseph. So they want Joseph to be erased from their sight. That's why they sold him to the Ishmaelite for an slavery. In Genesis 35, we can find the family of Jacob. Jacob's family was of a dysfunctional family. There were 12 brothers having come from different mothers. And Jacob had sinned and violated God's plan for marriage. As a result, there was a division in the family. There was a division in the family. Reuben, being the firstborn, was so angry, who should have been the heir of the family, as well as the other brothers, because Joseph was so loved and favored by his father Jacob. And so we can see in Genesis 37, verse 3-4, it says here, "Now Israel loved Joseph more than all his children, because he was the son of his old age, and he made him a coat of many colors. And when his brethren saw that their father loved him more than all his brethren, they hated him and could not speak peaceably unto him." So this is how the result of Jacob's sin and violation against marriage. Jacob's family was a family full of envy and of jealousy. They hated Joseph. Could you imagine the relationship that they had? Brothers against their own brothers, against their own brother Joseph. So, to make the hatred against Joseph, in number to Joseph's foretelling of a dream, we can see that in verses 6-7 it says that, "And he said unto them, Hear, I pray you, this dream, which I have dreamed. For behold, we were binding sheaves in the field, and lo, my sheaf arose and also stood upright, and behold, your sheaves stood round about and made obeisance to my sheaf." So, if you are the elder brother of the family, and your younger brother is telling you that someday, because of his dream, they will be bowing down to Joseph. So, it caused them more hatred against Joseph because of his dream. And to make it worse, is Joseph's foretelling of a dream, but God's hand was upon Joseph. And this was not just another dream, but this was a form of divine revelation. The scriptures have not been canonized, and God would sometimes speak to someone through a dream. The Bible was not yet complete, so God can speak to somebody through a dream. And God spoke to Joseph. Joseph was already hated by his brethren, and now he is telling a dream. Hey guys, I had a dream, and you all bow down to me. Isn't that a nice dream? It wasn't a nice dream because the brothers don't wanna hear the dream. So it makes the relationship more worse because of the dream of Joseph. So number three is the brothers' fury. Genesis 37 verse 8. And his brethren said to him, "Shalt thou indeed reign over us? Or shalt thou indeed have dominion over us?" And they hated him yet the more for his dreams and for his words. In verse 11 it says there, "And his brethren envied him, but his father observed the same." So we see the failure of a friendship, the hatred of his brethren. Letter B is the betrayal of his brethren. Genesis 37 verse 27, "Come, let us sell him to the Ishmaelites, and let us not our hand be upon him, for he is our brother and our flesh." And his brethren were content. So they betrayed Joseph by selling him to the Ishmaelites. If you were Joseph and your brothers or your loved ones did the same thing to you, how would you feel? How would you feel? It's your own brothers who will betray. It's very hard. So we see the failure of friendship. And number two, the focus of the faithful. But before that, before we go to number two, is we see hatred in the family. A family that hatred is existing is not a happy family. Amen? Sad to say that when bitterness comes, we see bitterness or hatred between brothers and sisters. We see also bitterness or against husband and wife. And it's very normal to a husband and wife. That bitterness also comes in the life of a husband and wife. Amen? Sometimes you will be out in the bed. Sister Precious is smiling and all the wives are listening. And it happens. Even me, I even experience most of the times. I'm not just telling you. But I'm experiencing it. Bitterness also is present in the relationship between husband and wife. And or even in the church. We are brothers in Christ. We are the body of Christ, but still, we are not perfect. Bitterness sometimes happens to every believer. And maybe you don't know, your shipmate has bitterness against you. That's why he cannot look at your face. Or when we welcome each other, we cannot shake the hands of our brothers. Because we have bitterness in our heart against our brothers. Amen? So, but Joseph is a different one. Joseph was a different one. So we see number two is the focus of the faithful. Your alignment comes to bitterness. Huh? I think bitterness is present in you. So we see the focus of the faithful. The focus of the faithful. Of all the experiences that Joseph had, Joseph remained faithful. His focus is on the Lord. Amen? His focus is on the Lord. Letter is the focus of faith. Joseph remained faithful to God even his brothers betrayed him. He became a slave. Could you imagine a slave in a far country and you don't have somebody to help, ask for help aside from the Lord? But the Lord was with Joseph. So his focus of faith, we see his focus of faith. In times of his trial, in Genesis chapter 39, we see here a story about Potiphar's wife and Joseph. Genesis chapter 39, verse 7. And it came to pass after these things that his master's wife cast her eyes upon Joseph. And she said, lie with me. But Joseph said, but in verse 8, but he refused and said unto his master's wife, behold, my master wotteth not what is with me in the house, and he had committed all that he had to my hand. Potiphar gave the full 100% trust to Joseph. But because of the seducing spirit that Potiphar's wife had, she wants Joseph to lie with her. And if you are Joseph, what you will do? If somebody will seduce you, will you be running or will you be staying? But what Joseph did, he refused. And it should be our spirit, our attitude, when it comes to temptation, we should refuse, just like Joseph. So Joseph remained faithful to God, even at times of trials in life. And number two, Joseph remained faithful or focused in his faith to God when he was falsely imprisoned. Because of that instance, of that situation, it caused Joseph to be in prison. His master Potiphar sent him to prison. You know, brethren, we cannot control the actions of others, but we cannot control but we can control our own reactions. We cannot control what others say about you, but we can control our response because of the power of the Holy Spirit. Yes. We see in the Bible that it is required in stewards that a man be found faithful. The Bible didn't say it is required for a man or a steward to be successful. But the Bible said it is required for a steward to be faithful. Joseph was not certainly successful because he was a slave. But he could make one choice, and that is to be faithful. And we can do the same thing. When it comes to trials in life, we should remain faithful. And to remember his upbringing and honor to God in all that he did. We see his focus of faith through his time in Egypt. There was not any record in the Bible that Joseph backslidden. First, when he was in a situation, as what I said in the event of seducing Potiphar's wife. And Joseph could have made excuses, but notice what Joseph did in Genesis chapter 39 verse 7. And it came to pass after these things that his master's wife cast her eyes upon Joseph, and she said, "Lie with me." So Joseph said to Potiphar's wife, "Through your husband, he has given me so much responsibility in many areas, but I am not to touch you because you are my master's wife." And so Joseph fled the room, but Potiphar's wife took the coat of Joseph as an evidence that Joseph did something to Potiphar's wife. But one thing, he did not took his character. Why? Because Joseph was focused on God. Even in his trial, he kept focused on the Lord. He was a man who keeps trusting on the Lord. We see integrity is keeping my commitment even after the circumstances. When I made the commitment, have changed. Integrity is to keep loving your wife when her health changes. Integrity is loving your wife when her health changes or when her behavior changes. That's integrity. Amen? Amen, wife? That's integrity. I'll repeat again. Integrity is to keep loving your wife when her health changes, if she becomes weak, and if her figure changes. That's integrity. Amen?
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Integrity is being faithful when everyone around you is cheating. Integrity is being faithful when everyone around you is cheating. That's integrity. Joseph was a man of integrity. He did not use his circumstances as an excuse to sin. But he kept on following God by faith. So we see his focus of faith. And now letter B is his focus on service. In Genesis chapter 40, verse 8, we see here that when Joseph was in prison, there was a butler and a baker, and they have both dream. These two both had a dream. And Joseph made an interpretation of their dream. So in prison, still Joseph, we see he's serving, his focus is serving. He was being betrayed by his own brothers. And then he became a slave. Now he is in prison. But Joseph focused and remained serving the Lord. He is serving others. He is serving others. Are you serving others? How is our service, my dear brethren? When we are being tried, when we have problems, can we still serve the Lord faithfully, just like Joseph? We see also in number 2 in Pharaoh's work. Pharaoh had a dream, and nobody could interpret the dream of Pharaoh. We can see that in Genesis 41:25. So from prison, now Joseph had the chance to go outside from the prison, because only Joseph could interpret the dream of the Pharaoh. So masaya, di ba? Now you are being in prison, now you have the privilege to go outside from the prison. Genesis 41:25 says, "And Joseph said unto Pharaoh, The dream of Pharaoh is one. God has showed Pharaoh what he is about to do." So Joseph interpreted the dream of Pharaoh that there will be 7 years of famine and 7 years of blessing. So we see Joseph's focus is just serving others, even in times, in trying times, in difficult times, or in blessing time. We see that whatever situation Joseph had in his life, he chose to be faithful and remain faithful to God. And number 3, we see here, the freedom of forgiveness. The freedom of forgiveness. Letter A is the forgiver spirit. The forgiver spirit. Genesis 45:4-5. And Joseph said unto his brethren, "Come near to me, I pray you." And they came near. And he said, "I am Joseph, your brother, whom ye sold into Egypt. Now therefore be not grieved, nor angry with yourselves, that ye sold me hither, for God did send me before you to preserve life." So we see here the attitude of Joseph. We see here how Joseph forgave his brothers, even though they betrayed him. The forgiver is free. 20 long years had passed by the time we come to Genesis 45. But in here we see the reunion and the forgiveness. In this account we see the reunion and the forgiveness. If you were Joseph, will you be doing the same? They know that you are in a position and in power. You can do everything you want just to revenge what they did against you. But Joseph, he did something that is very, very different. Joseph is now second in command in the nation of Egypt at that time. So this is very exciting moment on the part of Joseph and even on the part of his brethren, his brothers. Do we have enemies in life? Did we hurt somebody before, maybe 20 years ago, and bitterness is still present in our heart? Is there someone among us? Or maybe 10 years ago, somebody refused you. You proposed to somebody, but she said no. And bitterness is becoming growing in your heart up to this time. Or somebody said something against you, and you feel hurt. What you will do? Will you do the same as what Joseph did? Or you want to, at this time, you want to try, write those names who had made wrong against you? Have you ever tried writing names who caused you bitter? Why not just pray for them? The best solution is to pray for them. When Joseph met his brothers, he did not say, he told his guards, "Guards, put them in prison." He did not say that. But instead, he spoke kindly to his brothers. He received them very happily and gladly. So, the forgiver is free. And number two is, he rejoiced in God's sovereignty. Genesis 45, verse 5. It says here, "Now therefore be not grieved, nor angry with yourselves, that ye sold me hither, for God did send me before you to preserve life." In Genesis chapter 15, verse 20, this is what Joseph said, "But as for you, he thought evil against me, but God meant it unto good to bring to pass, as he this day to save much people alive." So this is the God's sovereignty. God's sovereignty. He rejoiced in God's sovereignty. God's sovereignty is, "He thought evil against me, but God meant it unto good." That's God's sovereignty. So, the forgiver is free. He received them gladly. He rejoiced in God's sovereignty. That's why whatever happens to us, there's a reason. There is a reason why things are happening in our lives. Romans 8:28 says, "And we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are called according to His purpose." So there is a reason why things are happening in our life. Sometimes painful things happen, but there is a reason why it happens to us. Amen. So the forgiver is free. And letter B is, the forgiven is free. The forgiven is free. His brothers were guilty of what they have done. They were living in fear. What will Joseph do to them? Kung ikaw yung nakagawa ng masama sa iba, ano yung nararamdaman? Diba? Parang nahiya. There is something you cannot explain. You have parang ayaw mong makita ng face to face yung tao na nakagawa ng masama sa iyo. Diba? So, the forgiven is free. They are free from their guilt. Genesis 50 verse 15. And when Joseph's brethren saw that their father was dead, they said, "Joseph will peradventure hate us, and will certainly requite us all the evil which we did unto him." So, meron silang agam-agam na if they will see Joseph, if they will show Joseph, maybe Joseph won't kill them. But the time they met Joseph, it was a different one. Joseph already forgave them. He already forgave his brothers. That's why their fear had gone, and they were freed from their guilt. In Isaiah chapter 53, verse 3, it says here, "He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. And we hid our faces from him. He was despised, and we esteemed him not." Before, when we were still living in this world, we are rejecting the Savior. We did reject the Savior. As what is Joseph's brothers, they rejected their brother Joseph. John 1:10-11, "He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not." Masakit, di ba? Your brothers will betray you. And to make it worse, they did something that is very evil against you. Could you still forgive them? How is our forgiveness? How is forgiveness in our lives, brethren? Are we exercising forgiveness in our lives towards our brothers who sin against us? Or we cannot move on because there is bitterness in our heart.